In 2001, African countries committed 15% of national budgets to the health sector in Abuja. But despite being ranked the largest economy in Africa, Nigeria has not kept the Abuja Declaration. One's Make Niger Stronger campaign, held at the cricket pitch of the University of Ibadan, commenced with a blood test where several students benefited from the exercise.
I just got to know about this yesterday, so I just had to run down here. On getting here, I noticed that it's a very good program, because I personally used to have issue with my status, because I was afraid that maybe negative or positive. But on getting here, I say, okay, they bring the stuff to the campus, so I think it's good for me to go. And so I'm very happy that I know my status, that I'm negative. I did blood pressure, I did HIV test, I did malaria test, I did my height, my weight, and so on.
The one campaign, it's a good campaign. I think it's about poverty, eradication, and then it's good, it's okay for Nigeria at large. But the Nigerian government, they are not really supporting the movement. But then people are just trying to, but I would just urge the government to try their possible best to make this thing, like, if not every week, like every month, people should do their checkup for free.
The campaign called One Campaign employs the services of stakeholders in different sectors to remind the government as it prepares to finalize its 2017 budget to invest in health as stipulated in the National Health Act 2014 and keep its commitment to the African Union's 2001 Abuja Declaration.
So the campaign is basically calling on government of Nigeria to increase investments in the health sector, particularly because the National Health Act, a law of the Federation that was passed in 2014, 2 years later, nothing has been done. And this is a law that guarantees the right to health for every citizen. And so we were wondering why 2 years later, nothing has been done, particularly because the law provides that 1% of the consolidated revenue of the Federation will be set aside to create a basic healthcare provision fund. And from that fund, 50% of it is supposed to be used to provide universal coverage for all Nigerians. So the question is, why has it not taken off?
Some champions, also known as foot soldiers of the campaign, lament the state of the health sector in the country and urge the government to increase the percentage allocated to health in the national budget.
As a Nigerian, you have the right to talk to your representative, either in the House of Assembly, House of Representative, or the Senate. So you have a right to lobby your policymaker and say, look, as a constituent, I'm concerned about the primary health care center in our community. I would like you to do something about it. I would like you to talk to the federal government. I would like you to also push it at your parliamentarian level that we have more allocations to the health sector. We do not have a choice. We don't want to be left behind. I mean, otherwise, Nigeria will be left behind, and we don't want to be left behind. Nigeria is about the giant of Africa, and Nigeria is supposed to be leading and setting the pace when it comes to health and basic provisions for citizens. Okay, so we don't want to be left behind. We do not have a choice. Although we've had challenges in the course of the campaigns, a lot of people come with negative attitudes. I hope Nigeria is not ripe for signing of petition. It doesn't work yet. It's going to work here, and it's working already.
You can see our health system. Even you, when you're sick, two things you're afraid of. One is, am I going to die from this sickness? That's the first, you understand, it comes to everybody's mind. Then the second one is, two, even if I approach the health sector, will I get a solution? And that's the worst fear any human being can have, because it will now kind of like give credence to the first fear you have. So we are looking at, you know, the government's kind of like bringing up the health system, revamping it. Declare emergency on the health system is very, very bad. If you go to the interior community, we are at the town, we still have our pharmacies that we can approach, we have doctors, but in a little shift into the communities, they don't even have access to ordinary public health care centers. We are not even talking about hospitals, like government hospitals, huge specialist hospitals, the primary healthcare centers, it's very, very difficult for them. You see women, they give birth at home with little or no care, you know, from traditionalists. And they're exposed to a lot of diseases like tetanus, exposed to measles and the rest of. These are things that when you're pregnant, as a pregnant woman, you go to the hospital, they help you manage this health situation until you deliver peacefully and your child is immunized properly. So we want to see a health system where everybody, irrespective of your status.
Nigeria's National Health Bill, which was signed into law in 2014, was enacted for the purpose of providing healthcare insurance to certain class of people who are actually deprived. One is a campaigning and advocacy organization of more than 7 million people around the world taking action to end extreme poverty and preventable disease, particularly in Africa. This phase of the campaign was championed by acts like YJ Fowles and Kate Henshaw.